Hello, my name is Dr. Asley. I'm a board-certified fellowship-trained spine surgeon, and I'm the medical director here in the Sacramento Spine Treatment Center. In this segment, I would like to talk to you about a procedure called epidural injection. It's a very commonly performed procedure. I consider it very safe, and every time I have an office, I send about 5 to 10 patients for this procedure. The indications for this procedure is neck, arm pain, or low back and a leg pain. If the pain is acute, let's say within 6 weeks, it works great, especially for the arm and leg pain. However, when we enter chronic pain, it also is pretty successful. Before we do that, let me brush you up in some anatomy. As you can see, spine is composed of multiple vertebrae stacked on top of each other. Once they stack on top of each other, they form the spinal canal. Of course, you have the base of the skull. Neural structure composed of brain, spinal cord, and nerve roots. These structures are encased in a membrane called dura. It's a very thin membrane, like paper thin, but it's pretty tough, and it's filled with fluid called cerebrospinal fluid. Why? It's a shock absorber. So actually the neural structures are floating in this fluid. And its function is basically absorption of trauma. If you fall down, you bang your head, with this fluid surrounding it, your brain doesn't get smashed against your skull and end up with a bruising in your brain. And the potential space, so actually the dura fills the entire neural canal. And the potential space between the dura and the bone, we call it epidural space. The way this procedure is done is that the patient comes in the day of procedure, maybe they get a sedative, and then patient lies down, and under x-ray guidance, when you have live x-ray, you put the needle through the spinous processes, either in the cervical spine or the lumbar spine. And as you advance the needle, you have fluoroscopy or x-ray that tells you where exactly the needle is. As the needle enters into the canal, right before it touches the dura, that's where you want to be, called epidural space, and then you inject. Now, epidural injection is the very same as we use for low back pain as for pregnancy. However, basically the name comes where you do the injection. However, in pregnancy you inject numbing medication to get rid of the pain, the labor. In this type of situation for low back and leg pain or neck and arm pain, we inject steroids. Why steroids? Because every time you have pain, either in your neck or your lower back, that means one part of the spine is inflamed, is on fire. That could be the disc or the nerve root that's irritated. Therefore, we use anti-inflammatory to calm the area, to bring down the pain. The way I explain it is that epidural injections is equivalent of taking 100 Motrin. You can't take 100 Motrin because if you do, it burns your liver, it burns your stomach. However, with the epidural injection, you put the anti-inflammatory right where it belongs. And that's how we control the pain. And as you can see, when the needle goes in, this is the cross-section of the spine. As you can see right here, that you have a vertebral body where the weight gets transmitted. And this hole, when they stack on top of each other, form the neural canal. As you can see, this is a cross-section of the spinal cord and is surrounded by dura. And there's a space between dura and the bone, we call it epidural space. So the needle comes from the back and stops right there, right as you enter the canal, and that's where we inject. And the goal is to basically bathe all these structures, all these nerve roots and spine, with steroids to calm the inflammation down. You can either go traditionally as an epidural injection right down the middle between the spinous processes, or you can do from the side into the neuroforaminal, we call it transforaminal technique. If you do have, if you've had surgery in the past and you have scar formation in the back, then we have to do transforaminally. That way we can avoid the scar tissue and deliver the steroids. Now, as I said, the efficacy of the spinal epidural injection is very good if the pain is acute. As the time goes by between the injury and the pain, as the pain gets chronic, the efficacy of the epidural injection decreases. Now, there are a few risks involved with this procedure, which are very minor. One is that if you put the needle too far down. You can see on the in this model. And actually, if you puncture the dura, then you start leaking cerebrospinal fluid. If that happens, what happens is that the brain that's floating, it settles down to the base of the skull, and patient ends up with a very bad headaches and photosensitivity. If that happens, which would be the day of procedure, then we need to take the patient back. And what they do is that they get a blood sample and inject it right around where the leak is, so the blood will clot and patch the hole. And it's very successful. Of course, the other complication that I've rarely heard of, I've never seen it, it hasn't happened to any of my patients, but I've heard of it in the literature, is that if you put the needle too deep into the neural structure, and that you end up with a nerve damage, which is not good. However, the people that we send our patients to are very good at these. They do these all day, and they do it under X-ray guidance. And chance of actually delivering this medication to the neural structures is very, very low, and I've never heard of it in my practice. Therefore, I consider this procedure very safe. It's very efficacious, especially if the pain is acute, and it's just an injection. And hopefully with the simple injection, we can avoid a surgical intervention. I hope you enjoyed the segment, and have a nice day.